Well, good evening and a warm welcome to St. Mary's Church. And we did look up a lighter for this Advent candle. Does anyone want to light it? Shall I do it? I'll do it. Right. If I can get this to light. Oh, look at that. Right. Good. We usually light the Advent candles on the Sundays of Advent, but there's no reason why we shouldn't light one for today. And actually, we should get them to do that for the Christingle tomorrow when the school children come in. The theme picks up on those themes of Advent and the second coming of Christ today. So we'll move on with our opening sentences. As we light this Advent candle, may its flame be for us a sign of hope. May its warmth be a symbol of God's love for us, and may it inspire us to be hope-bearers, people of compassion and integrity, as we gather in the name of Jesus, who is the light of the world. Amen. Shall we pray this together? God of gods and King of kings, be with us as we seek to know more of your truth. Speak to us by your word and your spirit. Help us to see Jesus and to hear his voice, not just for today, but for all days, we pray. Amen. I don't know whether you know this song. It's not a very new one, but it may not be new to you. So do join in as you get to know it all. And if you already know it, we sing How Great is Our God or The Splendor of the King, depending on what you want to call it.
Today's reading is taken from the Gospel of Luke. And there will be strange signs in the sun, moon, and stars. And here on earth, the nations will be in turmoil, perplexed by the roaring seas and strange tides. People will be terrified at what they see coming upon the earth, for the powers in the heavens will be shaken. Then everyone will see the Son of Man coming on a cloud with power and great glory. So when all these things begin to happen, stand and look up, for your salvation is near. Then he gave them this illustration. Notice the fig tree or any other tree. When the leaves come out, you know without being told that summer is near. In the same way, when you see all these things taking place, you can know that the kingdom of God is near. I tell you the truth, this generation will not pass from the scene until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will disappear, but my words will never disappear. Watch out! Don't let your hearts be dulled by carousing and drunkenness, and by the worries of this life. Don't let that day catch you unaware, like a trap. For that day will come upon everyone living on the earth. Keep alert at all times, and pray that you might be strong enough to escape these coming horrors and stand before the Son of Man.
I was saying on Sunday that this is, I think, one of those more difficult passages in the Bible. And the reason why I think it's one of the more difficult passages in the Bible is not because there's inherently anything very difficult in it. Jesus says that I am coming to save you, that even when there are coming horrors, that if we pray, God will help us. But because one thing he says in it doesn't seem to have happened, and that is that he says in it that the end of the world will come before the generation he's living in has died. And it seems a very difficult thing to tally with the fact that that didn't happen, and we don't really know why. We don't understand whether it's a miswriting of what was Jesus said, a misinterpretation of him saying something after all the words were written down a good while after he was on earth, or what and why those who wrote them down in the way they did. But certainly the reality that the end of the world could happen at any time is still very true, and it could happen within this generation. And it's one of those things that challenges us and provides us with reason to make sure that we are ready, always ready to face what is ahead of us and to face those things that we might be scared of, anything that we might be worried about at the end of time. And we face it with hope because Jesus says, look up and do not be afraid, because your salvation is near. Jesus has lived on this earth and died and gone to heaven and will come back to take us to heaven. And he longs for us and loves us and is there to strengthen and help us. And so he encourages us that we are not to be those who worry about the end of time, but he also reminds us that it's going to be difficult, that we need to pray. We need to pray that whatever comes to us, whatever difficulties, whether they are just difficulties like the ones that John was facing as he wrote this down, because the church was very much in persecution, and there were all sorts of things happening which seemed to be really, to them, the end of the world. And for us, we may look around and think there are many things happening which feel like the end of the world and a great challenge to us. But we can have the certainty and surety that Jesus has it under control and he can help us. But we must pray and we must stay firm and we must be careful not to be those who get ourselves led away into things that might cause us to have a bit of fun for a moment, but just simply don't lead us into the right things. For integrity of who we are is important to what we are will be. And being in those people who are full of the integrity of God is one of the things that is important to how we are prepared. That if we are living honestly and rightly before God, then we are ready. And I know that the truth is, none of us is perfect, and none of us can really think, actually, I'm so ready to meet God that there's going to be no faults that I'm going to present to him. The reality is that we present ourselves as we are. And the reality is he already knows us as we are and he already loves us as we are. But we seek to move from one degree of glory to another. We seek to go forward. And the honesty and integrity of Christian people is that they seek to move from where they are to somewhere better, that they seek to grow in love and generosity and kindness, that they seek to build community and reach out to those in need. And if we're doing those things, if we're doing those things and we're seeking to do them more, then we don't need to worry. And if we're having a really difficult time and we're not managing to do those things, but we want to and we know that it's just a difficult time we're going through, that's okay too. Our Saviour doesn't demand that we are perfect. Our Saviour comes to us in our imperfection. And we'll think more of that as we come to Christmas and as we think about those stories that are coming ahead of us. So I don't really have an answer to why this passage has its difficult bit, but I imagine that when we get to heaven, we'll find that it's really quite straightforward. What I do know is that God is with us, and God wants us to be those who are living in a way that brings hope and joy to us, and hope and joy to others, and sets us for our eternity, where we will live in those right and integral ways. Pray that God may help us to do that. Amen. So we're going to have a piece of music, and it's quite lively, and maybe a moment to reflect and just rejoice in what God gives to us as we listen to this, the Trad Jazz Praise Band. Try to say that quickly, listen to this song. You may know the words, you may want to think about the words, or you may just want to enjoy the music and enjoy thinking about how wonderful it's going to be when God takes us to the heavenlies. Imagine heaven's going to be rather good. Oh, I did have some pictures I was going to show during that of flames and things. I completely forgot. There you are. I hope you just had. I did really want to have a video, but it wasn't possible to run a video at the moment with the system that we're running. So I thought, you know, sort of a dancing video would be fun. So I did think of trying to do some dancing flames and make them. So there you are. There's the dancing flames, and here we are. Turning to God to admit that we are what we are, and knowing that he will help us with the things that are wrong and need to be corrected. When the Lord comes, he'll bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us confess our sins. Lord of heaven and earth, sometimes we don't recognize your signs of love and compassion among us. Forgive and enrich us. Sometimes you don't recognize your signs of change and challenge. Forgive and enlighten us. Sometimes we don't recognize your signs of reconciliation and healing. Forgive and encourage us. Sometimes we do recognize your signs of opportunity, but lack the confidence to act on them. Forgive and empower us. In the name and strength of Jesus we pray. Amen. God promises to all who follow that he will take away our sins and reset us on the path of life. Hear God's word, know God's forgiveness, feel God's peace. It is done. So be it. Amen. Eternal God, hope of the world, we cannot grasp the immensity of your being, yet all around us we catch glimpses of your power. You speak to us in nature's blessing. You speak to us through science and creativity. You reveal yourself in the love and the care and support of those around us. You show yourself when we most need to see you, when we least expect it. We see your hand at work. We read your word time and time again, and suddenly we are amazed by seeing something new. Eternal God, we adore you. Amen. Your voice sings through creation, from the dawning of light to the end of time. You are our beginning and our end, and our days are held in the palm of your hand. O God, you are the beginning and end of all things. We pray to you for those who nurture new life, both physical and spiritual, for teachers and leaders, and those who have inspired our faith, for midwives and prophets, for the people who call us to start again, for all who are at the beginning of a new adventure of faith, and for all who feel that it is time to lay down some responsibilities, for children growing up in challenging times, for those we know who are approaching the end of their life, and for all who watch at the bedside of the sick. Give us expectant hearts as we listen for your voice. Wait for the Lord, his day is near. Wait for the Lord, be strong, take heart. Your voice sings through scripture and through the words of the prophets, calling us back to your heart of love and filling us with hope in your vision of a better world where justice and gentleness shape our lives. God, our protector and provider, we pray to you for trust in you when our world seems so troubled, for faithfulness to your work of life in your church, for a narrative of hope in society and in our leadership, for the courage to challenge the lies of exclusion and inequality, and for a new beginning. Give us expectant hearts as we listen for your voice. Wait for the Lord. His day is near. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Take heart. Your voice sings in the darkness where people are lost and alone, distant from home, sick or afraid. O God, you mend what is broken. We pray to you for all refugees and asylum seekers, for a decent, humane and workable immigration system, for the collective will to face our responsibility for the conflict-torn areas of the world, for Ethiopia as the Prime Minister escalates war against the rebels, for Afghanistan as winter begins to bite and food is in short supply, for support workers and volunteers working in rescue, and for all who are in danger today. Give us expectant hearts as we listen for your voice. Wait for the Lord. His day is near. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Take heart. Your voice sings in the witness of faithful people through the ages, the ones who stood on the edges and those who felt the pain of being excluded. God of peace and wholeness, we pray to you for the chance encounters of the week ahead, for friends and family and the blessing they add to our lives, for everyone that has helped us through the past year, for people we've usually overlooked, for the bereft and bereaved, and for those who watch over them. Give us expectant hearts as we listen for your voice. Wait for the Lord. His day is near. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Take heart. Your voice sings in the desert of the land which is dry and parched, in the hidden places where you are at work, and in the quiet places that are full of unseen acts of kindness. God of peace and wholeness, we pray to you for the chance encounters. Oh, we've had that one. Your voice sings as a future is yet as known. You ask us for our trust and you point us to the power of our everyday choices. God of time and space, we pray to you for greater commitment to preserving the resources of the planet, for the true love of neighbours near and far, for lives that honour your justice and your truth, for gentleness with ourselves and one another. Give us the ability to wait patiently for you. Give us hearts that stay faithful, hands that are ready to reach out to others, and lives that are shaped by your love. Give us expectant hearts as we listen for your voice. Wait for the Lord. His day is near. Wait for the Lord. Be strong. Take heart. We join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Dad in heaven above, let everyone look up to you and the area where you are in charge grow. May what you want happen on earth as perfectly as it does in heaven. Please give to us what we need for today. Forgive us when we think or do wrong things, just as we don't hold it against those who hurt us. Guide us away from whatever we might want, but is unhelpful to us, and protect us from all that is nasty and destructive. For you are in charge for everything. You have the power to do it, and you are awesome. You always were, you are now, and always will be. Amen. Our final song is this one, Cornerstone, which you may know or you may not. But again, I think it's quite easy to pick up.
Trust the sweetest friend. Dressed in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne.
So may your heart be at peace and your mind be at rest. May you be confident in who you are and share God's gifts of light, hope, and grace with those you meet and those you pray for. And may the blessing of God fill your hearts with hope this day and evermore. Amen. Loving God, as we end our time together and leave this place, let us go in hope, live by hope, and be signs of hope for all to see. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, that brings us to end of today's worship. I'm sorry about only having the sound on one side of the all the music, but there we are. Probably most people didn't notice that, but being a sound engineer by background, I kind of go, oh. Anyhow, we'll sort it out probably in about 2 minutes after the service. It only went wrong just before the service. God bless. Have a lovely week, and look forward to being with you again next week. Next week, we're in Rawcliffe.